So here's another video on Dali Opticon 1 crossover. In order to replace the caps in the crossover, the first thing you need to do is to take out the drivers. The treble driver and the bus driver. And to do that, you need to unscrew these screws. Hex screws. Oh, like that. Then you'll have to unplug the spade connectors for the speakers. If you have problem with the spade connector locking mechanism, remember that you can there is a little piece of locking mechanism here, and you need to push from this side with a sharp small screwdriver to push the locking mechanism out. Let's see if I can get the anyway, you just need to take them out and then you can remove the crossover. The original stock crossover uses Bennig electrolytic bipolar condensers. The bigger one is 33 microfarads and the smaller one is 6.8 microfarads. And these are the same values that can be found in the Opticon 2 crossover. I am replacing them with foil caps, the cross cap from Jantzen Audio and Mundorf M-Cap EVO aluminum oil. So this is the stock one. As you can see, the original, the stock condensers, capacitors are smaller than the new ones, but it's not a problem because you can place them as you can see here, and you can add some locking to the plates so they won't be vibrating too much. And and that's basically everything. You need to put the crossover back to the speaker case, then you need to connect the drivers and screw them in place. And that's all. This is the third or fourth pair of my speakers that I'm upgrading with foil condensers, sorry, foil capacitors, and the difference is tremendous. It's not something that you have to listen to notice. It's something that it's noticeable already at replacing the capacitors, and I'm expecting the speakers to sound even better after burn-in. So that's, well, that would be all. Thank you.